If we want to refer to second number of group, the usual notation used is per 2. So we were discussing about array. So per was array in which 5 elements were there. So if we want to refer to second number, that is 88, then the usual notation used is per 2. So per 2 is usual notation. Similarly, the fourth number of groups group is referred to as per 4. So fourth number is 23 and it is referred to as per 4. However, in C, the fourth number is referred as per 3. This is because in C, the counting of elements begins with 0. So here 23 is per 3. So this is because in C, the counting of elements begins with 0 and not 1. Thus, in this example, per 3 refers to 23 and per 4 refers to 96. In general, the notation would be per I, where I can take a value 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4 depending on the position of element being referred. Here per is subscripted variable, that is array, whereas I is its subscript. So per is a subscripted variable and I is its subscript. Thus, an array is a collection of similar elements. So array is collection of similar elements. These similar elements could be all ints or all floats or all chars, etc. So they can be all ints, all floats or all chars, etc. Usually the array of characters is called string. So array of characters is called string. Whereas an array of ints or floats is called simply an array. So array of ints or floats is called an array. Remember that all elements of any given array must be same type. So all elements of any array must be of same type. That is, we cannot have an array of 10 numbers of which 5 are ints and 5 are floats. So we cannot do operations on an array which is of 10 number and in which 10 are ints and 10 are floats. So all should be same. That is, all should be a float or all should be ints. A simple program using array. Let us try to write a program to find average marks obtained by a class of 30 students in a test. Main, int average, sum is equal to 0. Int marks 30. So average and sum are integers, then I is an integer. Int marks 30, so marks 30 is an array. So that is for array declaration. Now for I is equal to 0, I is less than or equal to 29 and I plus plus, that is incrementation. So 29 is written because I starts from 0. So from 0 to 29 total digits are 30. So hence 29 is written. Now parenthesis starts, that is printf slash n enter marks. So here we are telling user to enter his marks. Now scanf percent d. So percent d is for integer and percent f is for float. So here we have all integers, that is average, sum and I are all integers. So percent d is written. Now comma ampersand marks. So marks, ampersand marks is an array. And I is written because in for loop we have written I. And we have here also already declared I as an integer. First, in third line, in fourth line, we have declared I is an integer also. Now ampersand marks is an array. Store data in an array. So that is comment. Scanf percent d and marks I, that is store data in an array. Now for loop. For loop, I is equal to 0, I is less than or equal to 29, I plus plus. sum is equal to sum plus marks I. That is sum plus marks I, that means read data from an array, that is new element from an array. So it starts from I is equal to 0 and it goes up to 29. Now I plus plus, that is incrementation. Now sum is equal to sum plus marks, that is next marks in an array. Average is equal to sum divided by 30, because there were 30 total of students marks. Now printf slash n average marks is equal to percent d comma avg. So here we are telling compiler to print on a next line that average marks is equal to percent d. That means average marks percent d is for integer and average was integer that we have defined in beginning of program. So slash n average marks is equal to percent d comma average. There is a lot of new material in this program, so let us take it apart slowly. So let us discuss about this program.